So you can fly to practical test standards, airspeed, bank, altitude, smack on. That's what the FAA wants, and that's what your CFI teaches.
But does that really prepare you for the real world? Does that give you the skills you need to get out of trouble? Well, maybe not.
But when you focus that much on the parameters of flight, you neglect the sensations. So then if you're in a flight situation where the sensations start to come in and those sensations are unfamiliar, that can degrade your performance.
Ed Wischmeyer studies loss of control accidents and, based on what he's learned, developed something he calls E3. And that caught the attention of AOPA Air Safety Institute boss Richard McSpadden.
So, Ed, to start with, can you summarize for people, what is E3, expanded envelope exercises? What is it?
E3 is really a philosophy and, of course, a bunch of exercises. And the idea is that pilots don't have accidents in their comfort zones. So if you can extend a pilot's comfort zone, that is their flight envelope, if you can expand that, then there will be more comfortable pilots, there'll be safer pilots, they'll get more joy from flying, and they'll probably fly more. So E3 is a philosophy that says, don't stop at the mechanics of the ACS or the regs or anything. Go beyond those and really see what the airplane will do and enjoy it.
Well, Richard explains more about E3 in his safety spotlight in the upcoming April issue of AOPA Pilot Magazine. And E3 exercises will soon be added into ASI's Focused Flight Review curriculum.
They're not really exercises with precise entry and exit parameters. That's not really the goal. The goal is to get a little farther outside your typical flight regime and just feel what that's like, so it doesn't surprise you if you ever find yourself there.
Well, there are many different exercises designed to safely help you learn the feel of your airplane when it gets outside of your normal operating envelope.
Certainly the poster child for E3 is what I call the 60-90s. You start at the plane at a speed comparable to flying downwind in the traffic pattern, and you're at altitude and with flaps retracted. Using full aileron deflection, bank to 60 degrees, turn 90 degrees of turn, then full aileron deflection the other way, turn 90 degrees, so it's left, right, left, right. But what's different about this is you don't worry about airspeed, you don't worry about precise bank angles, and you don't worry about altitude, so that you can focus on the sensations and see how much is going on, rather than being distracted by airspeed and altitude.
Well, other exercises help pilots learn how to deal with botched base to final turns. Well, Tom, I'm looking forward to learning more about those exercises and going out in the 170 and trying them.
Yeah, it does sound like it'd be an interesting exercise. And the important thing is, you know, to always remember that the FAA minimums are just that, and that we all need to kind of expand our envelope, if you will, and understand
right.
The sensations of the airplane and be able to go out and be safe flying the airplane pretty much in any part of the envelope.